Say it this way, please.
Thank you, sir, for your brief introduction. I would like to thank the audience for giving me the chance to give a talk on CMN. Before going to CMN, we should know about the myeloproliferative disorders. Here, it is a clonal disorder of pseudophytes that arises in the hematopoietic stem cells or the early Golgi vessels. It is characterized by the dysregulated production of particular lineage of mature myeloid cells with fairly normal maturation, and exhibit a variable tendency to progress to acute leukemia and shared abnormalities of hemostasis and fibrosis, overlap between the clinical features. CML is a clonal myeloproliferative neoplasm. Dysregulated production and uncontrolled proliferation of mature and maturing granulocytes with fairly normal differentiation. Fusion of two genes, that is BCR and ABL genes, resulting in BCR ABL fusion protein, and final result abnormal chromosome 22 called as Philadelphia chromosomes. Final product of BCR ABL fusion protein, it is a dysregulated tyrosine kinase protein. Uncontrolled production of mature and maturing granulocytes, predominantly neutrophils but also basophils and eosinophils also increase. And it is a triphasic or biphasic clinical course. It has three phases, one is chronic and the other blast phases phase. The chronic phases, the median survival, it is the chronic phase before the coming of imatinib. The chronic phase, the median survival is 5 to 6 years. For accelerated phase, it is 6 to 9 months, and blast phase phase, the median survival is only 3 to 6 months. How to suspect CML early stage? Here there is one case study. A 45-year-old male presented during his corporate annual checkup. His WBC count is more than 17,000, and the competition more interested by his cholesterol level only, and advised him to limit cheese and animal fare. 6 months later, the patient presented with complaints of pain in the left flank pain and of increasing diurnal asthenia that did not allow him to keep up with his normal life activities. And he underwent evaluation and found the basic blood test. The WBC count is more than 37,000, and the peripheral blast in peripheral shows only 2% of blast cells are there, and the spleen size is increased, and it is about 6 cm from the left subcostal margin. The hemoglobin is 10.7. Patient underwent cytogenetic analysis 20 by 20. The Philadelphia chromosome is positive. Bone marrow analysis confirmed the diagnosis of chronic phase of CML. 100% Philadelphia chromosome is seen in the metaphysis cells. The patient diagnosed as CML in the chronic phase. What is leukemia? It is a cancer of the blood or bone marrow, characterized by an abnormal proliferation of blood cells, usually WBC cells, and diffuse replacement of bone marrow by neoplastic cells. Leukemia classification based on cell type, cell maturation potential, and cell capacity for circulations. This pictogram shows the normal development of hematopoiesis, and the hematopoietic stem cells given rise to pro-erythroblast, myeloblast, lymphoblast, monoblast, and megakaryoblast. From this eosinophil, basophil, neutrophils, granulocytes are arise, and lymphocytes and monocytes are also there. The epidemiology of CML, leukemia accounts for 3% of all cancers in humans. Incidence is 5 to 10 cases per 1 lakh population. CML accounts for 15 to 20% of all adult leukemias. Incidence is 1 to 2 cases per 1 lakh populations, acute slightly more frequently in men when compared with female. The median patient age at diagnosis is 55 to 60 years. CML is rare in persons is less than 19 years. In Indian scenario, it comprises of 30 to 60% of all the premiers. The male to female ratio is 3:1 in PMS. The median age of diagnosis is 32 years. 89.5% presents in chronic phase. 85, more than 85% is presented with chronic phase. Remaining 50% is only in the ulcerative phase and blastocystis phase. And the mostly is present in the chronic phase. The most common symptom was patient will present with pain in the left groin and knees have extreme tiredness. And the routine checkup, it shows the WBC count is more. The most common age is, it is concerned 40 years and this classification is depend upon the so-called syntax are there and the hash code indexes are used for the prognostic of the chronic myeloid leukemia. What is the cause of such increased proliferation? The molecular genetics of CML, the Philadelphia chromosomes was originally generated by workers in Philadelphia and it is the first genetic abnormality to be associated with a human cancer. The result of balanced translocation between the chromosome 9 and chromosome 22. The derivative of chromosome 22 is significantly smaller and it is called as Philadelphia. Philadelphia chromosome is present in hematopoietic cells from patients with CML. Therefore, the Philadelphia chromosome is acquired and not inherited one. The development of chronic phase CML appears to be direct result of BCR-ABL transition protein, which results in development of uncontrolled proliferation of transformed cells, and there is a disorder in maturation, and it is escape from apoptosis, altered in interaction with the cellular matrix. This results in leukemia. The progression of CML from chronic phase to ulcerative phase, blastocystis is a complex one, and it is a multi-step process. Also, it appears to involve the constant expression of BCR-ABL1 tyrosine kinase enzyme. This pictogram shows the bone marrow karyotyping of a CML patient. Here, there is a chromosome 9 and 22. That is a balanced translocation between the chromosome 9 and 22 results in the fusion of BCR-ABL protein. The risk factors for CML, most of the patients are present with the Philadelphia chromosome. The cause of the translocation that gives rise to Philadelphia chromosome cannot be identified. The factors that do pose a risk for CMLs are, one is high dose radiation, patient exposure to high dose radiation, and it is one accidental in nature, and therapy related radiation is also one of the risk factors for the CML, and the high body mass index, and the exposure to benzene compounds, chemicals, smoking and low immunity. The factors that do not pose the risk factor is one is the family history of CML. Coming to phases of CML, CML has three phases. One is chronic phase, accelerated phase and blastocystis. Approximately 90% of patients are diagnosed in CML with the chronic phase. If left untreated, after 3 to 5 years of CML in chronic phase, progress to isolated phase or blastocystis phase. CML patient in a doctor's clinic, mostly patients will present with asymptomatic and diagnosed incidentally through CBC report preliminarily, and it is confirmed through bone marrow karyotyping. In symptomatic, most common symptoms are, one is the weakness or fatigability in the patient, and the recurrent infection or fever is there, and spontaneous bleeding episodes due to the low thrombocytes count. The common signs are, patient has palpable splenomegaly and complaints of left groin pain, and CBC report is preliminary and confirmed. It is confirmed through the bone marrow biopsy doing karyotyping. First suspicion will arise through CBC. Here, this is the normal CBC picture. The normal WBC count is 4000 to 11000. Neutrophil count is normally 45 to 77%. Lymphocyte is 18 to 24%. Monocyte is 5 to 10%. Eosinophil is 3 to 7%. Basophil is 0 to 2%. And platelets count is normally 1.2 4 lakhs. But in CML patient, the WBC count is more than 20,000. and the blast in the chronic phase is less than 15%. For in accelerated phase, the blast count is 15 to 30%. If the blast count is more than 30%, then patient comes on the blast crisis phase. And the basal is also increased, but in accelerated phase, the basal count is more than 20%. Platelets in chronic phase is normal, or in accelerated it is decreased or increased, but in blast crisis phase, the platelet count is decreased. The marrow, in bone marrow, is hypercellular in nature in all the three phases. The diagnostic workup of CML, one is history and physical examination, including spleen palpation, and the routine CBC, complete blood count with differential and platelet count, chemistry profile, and the HLA testing, patients who are undergoing for all the bone marrow transplantation, and bone marrow aspiration and biopsy, and it is confirmed with bone marrow cytogenetics. If bone marrow collection is not feasible, then use the FISH. FISH is done in the peripheral blood specimen with dual probes for DCR and ABL genes. The determination of platelets and the low individual high risk are the so-called index. The so-called index has four parameters. One is age and the size of the spleen from the left costal margin and percentage of blast cells and platelet counts are taken in this. Patient is classified in the so-called index as low risk, intermediate risk, high risk. Those patients on low risk, the ratio, the percentage is less than 80%. In intermediate risk is 80 to 120 and high risk is more than 120. The BCR ABL mutation analysis done by the RT-PCR. This is the picture of the patient in peripheral blood smear of CML patient. The count of leukocyte is increased, it is more than 1 lakh and the differential count is shows all cells of neutrophil series, blasts is only 2% of blasts are seen. Myelocytes more than metamyelocytes and neutrophils cytochemistry is abnormal, it has low NAB score and basophilic is 90% of cases, thrombocytosis if low platelets considered. Bone marrow pathology in CML, the granulocytic maturation pattern same as in the peripheral blood. And the increased reticulum fibrosis and vascularity, erythroid islands are reduced in number and size, the dwarf megakaryocytes are seen, pseudo cancer cells and C2 histocytes are seen, iron laden macrophages are reduced or absent in the CML feature. The diagnosis of CML, the typical findings in the blood and bone marrow require the detection of Philadelphia chromosome or its product the BCR ABL fusion MR microRNA on the BCR ABL protein. The conventional cytogenetic karyotyping is the first method to diagnose the CML and this one is the fluorescein in situ hybridization, it is done in the peripheral blood also, and another one is the mutational analysis, it is done by the RT-PCR method. Southern blot techniques is rarely used and western blotting, it is low sensitive in nature. Most CML patients are diagnosed in the chronic phase. Here the blast cells is only 2%. In the blast cases where the number of blasts is more than 30%. The fluorescein in situ hybridization pictures shows the two probes with BCR and ABL probes. Coming to mutational analysis of chronic phase, it is a qualitative RT-PCR allowed for the diagnosis of chronic myeloid leukemia, and quantitative RT-PCR is used to quantify the amount of disease. Allows for the identification of cryptic BCR ABL translocation, does not protect a bone marrow aspect for optimal results. The diagnosis of CML, moving towards the molecular method. First one, it is the hematological diagnosis and cytogenetics. Now it is detected with FISH and RT-PCR method. Differential diagnosis for chronic myeloid leukemia, one is leukemic reaction, juvenile myelomonocytic leukemia, chronic myelomonocytic leukemia and atypical CML, chronic eosinophilic leukemia, chronic neutrophilic leukemia, other myeloproliferative neoplasms like polycythemia vera and myelofibrosis, essential thrombocytosis, other philadelphia chromosome positive malignancies, other differential diagnosis for CML. Diagnosis keeping the chronic phase. In chronic phase, the disease progression is 4 to 6 years to isolated phase, and up to 1 year the blast stage is a few weeks is absent further to come to the actual blast stage phase. The 85% of patients present in the chronic phase, and less than 15% marrow blast cells are there, the count is less than 15% in chronic phase. In isolated phase, the white blast is there, patient will complain of fever and bone pain, and blast number of blasts is 15 to 30%, and the 15 to 30% are there. Blast stages, poor prognostic rapidity is fatal in nature. More than 30% of blasts are seen in the blast stages phase. Definition for isolated phase of CML, the 10 to 19% blasts in the peripheral blood are in bone marrow. Peripheral blood basophils count is more than 20%. Platelets count is less than 1 lakh or more than 1 lakh. It is progressive splenomegaly and increasing WBC count and unresponsive therapy. And the cytolytic evaluation is there in the isolated phase of chronic myeloid leukemia. The blastic phase of CML, blast in the peripheral blood is more than 20%, or in the bone marrow, it is more than 30%. Large foci clusters of blasts are seen in the bone marrow. Presence of extramedullary infiltrates like inflammatory sarcoma are seen in the blast phases of CML. Clinical event, what is the optimal frontline therapy for CML? The principles of CML treatment, the relative symptoms of hyperleukocytosis, splenomegaly and thrombocytosis. The treatment is hydration and chemotherapy, previously 2-sulfan and hydroxyurea is given. Control, prolonging the chronic phase, non-QOT attempt, one is the usage of tyrosine kinase inhibitors, alpha interferon and chemotherapy, and chemotherapy with hydroxyurea and 2-sulfan. The treatment options for CML, potential cure with allogeneic hematopoietic stem cell transplantation. Disease is controlled without cure using the tyrosine kinase inhibitors, and the palliative therapy with cytotoxics like hydroxyurea. Factors influencing choice of therapy, one is the phase of CML and availability of donor for allogeneic stem cell transplant, and patient age, presence of medical comorbidities, and response to treatment with tyrosine kinase inhibitors. This is the high study, the landmark study in CML. Here it is a randomized study. Here the number of patients taken is 1206. Here it is randomized to one group for imaginary mislead, and another group is interferon alpha and cytosine albinocyte. There is a crossover is there when the loss of malignant cytolytic response and complete hematological response, and green WBC count are increased, and there is intolerance to treatment, the crossover is done, and failure to achieve the malignant cytolytic response at 12 months, and failure to achieve complete hematological response at 12 months. Request to discontinue the with interferon alpha, the patient are transferred to imaginary study. The hematological response with imaginary is 96% with imaginary, and only 67% in the interferon alpha and cytosine albinocyte. The cytogenetic response with imaginary is 83% when compared with it is 20% in the interferon alpha and cytosine albinocyte. The overall survival is increased with the imaginary. The initial treatment, the tyrosine kinase inhibitors are for the first line therapy in chronic phase of CML. The other agents are dasatinib, nilotinib is also used. It is comes under the first line according to NCCN guidelines category 1. The survival of CML by therapy with tyrosine kinase inhibitors, 20 years ago is 85%, and interferon alpha is 23%. And it is chemotherapy, it is very low when compared with the interferon alpha and imatinib. This is updated ENN 2013 recommendation, focus on molecular response for the tyrosine kinase inhibitors. Here baseline, it is not applicable for optimal response, and it is warning sign in the high risk or clonal cytogenetic abnormalities. For failure case, it is not applicable. In three months, the PCR ABL is ABL1 is less than 10%, and Philadelphia chromosome is less than 35%. for optimum response.